Let's worship the Lord together. He's worthy.
Prosper when the darkness falls. See you. I'm gonna see a victory, for the battle belongs to you, Lord.
I'm gonna see a victory. Oh, yes.
I'm gonna see a victory, for the battle belongs to you, Lord.
Hallelujah. We magnify you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We cannot be set back. Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
Mender of the broken.
fire of my soul.
Redeemer of all yesterdays,
oh, I will bless you, Lord. Maker of the heavens, the ocean and the sky.
I will bless. Filled with the noise. is my soul. Mercy and goodness gives me assurance that I'll see His glory. Face to face.
What a day, what a glorious day that will be. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Well, we're just so happy to have Brother Joe, Bert, Enrique, and Tyler here. Tyler's just going to come and leave a word of testimony. And Joe, Bert, I'll get you just to come up and turn the mic on where that's going to be your mic. And Tyler, you come up. Joe, Bert, turn the mic on so I don't have to handle it. And then just give him a moment. He'll step out of the way. And then, Tyler, you're going to come and testify. And okay, he's not going to hold it, though. You're just going to, you can hold it for him. Okay, come right up. You're both masked anyway, so just go ahead. You hold it for him there. A little miscommunication. Okay.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
Glad to be home. Isn't God good?
Amen.
I know that when I look back over my life and I see all the things God's done for me, it just absolutely amazes me. Not a whole lot of people know this, but I've struggled with depression for a lot of my life. After my parents split and everything, I was, well, really depressed. I considered suicide a couple of times. I used to go for runs, and I'd be out on the road, and every time a car would pass, I would think about throwing myself out in front of it and just being done with all of this. I wasn't overly, I didn't have a lot of friends in high school. I had a couple of people I liked to hang out with. There's a couple of people I didn't mind being with, but I was just really depressed and I didn't really know where to turn. I used to sit at the foot of my bed and I'd have a knife out and I'd be trying so hard to pull it into my body, and I never could. And I always thought of myself as a coward. And I would do this sometimes every night in a week, and it was rarely ever that I went any more than a couple of days without wanting to just get everything over with. But there was one time we went to, I think it was a youth convention, maybe it was Youth Explosion, and I was down on the altar and I said, God, if you're there, show me, because I feel so alone right now. And in that moment, I was taken back. I was looking back into my room when I was sitting at the foot of my bed and I was trying so hard to just end everything right there and pull the knife into myself. And though I didn't see it that night, whenever I was looking back and I was standing in that altar looking back on that moment, I saw another man sitting on the floor beside me, in front of me, trying to pull the knife away from me, keeping that knife from going into my chest. And I knew right then that God wasn't done with me yet.
Amen.
That everything that I had been through, that even in my depression, in my struggle, when I felt alone, when I felt as if I couldn't go another step, God was carrying me. And it's only because of the grace of God that I'm here today, and I'm so thankful to God for everything He's done.
Amen. And you know, that may sound really extreme, but there's a lot of people out there that are suffering today, and we just need to have compassion and be there as the church so that people can receive what they need from the Lord. So Brother Gilbert's going to grab his notes and he's going to come back to the pulpit. He's going to preach to us. He is from Lethbridge, Alberta. He'll probably tell us a little bit about himself. Amen. We're so happy to have him and happy to have each one of you in the house of the Lord. And we pray that God will bless you really good today, that he'll lift you up and you'll have a reason to live in Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, church. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I'm nervous. Oh, hallelujah. Can we worship the name of the Lord in this place? Hallelujah. 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 Can we worship the name? Hallelujah. God is in this place. Worship. He's ministering to us right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Why don't we shout with a voice of triumph? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you for your goodness. Hallelujah. Lord, thank you, God, for bringing us once again in the house of prayer. Hallelujah. God, we cannot do anything without you, Jesus. We cannot do anything without you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 I'm blessed. I'm glad to be here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Pastor Gowan, for allowing me to stand in this pulpit. Hallelujah. It's my first time being in St. George, you know. Been in New Brunswick for the last semester. I'm always in Fredericton. I don't go out. So I'm happy to be in a different city. You know, trying to find a new place, you know. God is everywhere. Wherever we go, God is always with us. So, hallelujah. I don't know. I don't know what God is going to do, but I believe that God is going to do something in our life this morning. I believe that God has a word for us this morning. Hallelujah. I'm not going to preach to you, but I'm going to preach to myself as well. Hallelujah. Because I believe that if God can touch my heart, he can touch yours as well. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If you have your Bible with you, the book of Romans chapter 5 verse 3, it says, and not only so, but we glory in tribulations also. Drawing the tribulation, work at patient and patient, experience and experience, hope and hope. Make it not a shame, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. I would like to title this message, The Power of Not Giving Up. The Power of Not Giving Up. Hallelujah. As we jump into Acts chapter 1 verse 8, it says, ye shall receive power. You shall receive power after that the Amen. Holy Ghost come upon you.
Amen.
And you shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem, in all Judea, in all Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Hallelujah. Yes. If we could stand, let's pray. Let's worship the name of the Lord. Lord Jesus, hallelujah. We thank you, God, hallelujah, for this morning. Thank you, God, for your word. Thank you, God, for your love and kindness unto us. Hallelujah. Lord, we cannot do anything, Lord, without you, Lord, in our life. Lord, we need you daily, Jesus. Lord, thank you, God, for opening our heart, opening our mind this morning, hallelujah, so we can understand what you wanted us to do in our life this morning, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, in Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Church, don't worry about tomorrow, because you will be distracted what God has for you today.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Think about now. Ask this question to yourself. Am I living for God today? Am I living for God today, or I just go to church because it's my daily basis. It's like my Sunday basis. I go to church this coming Sunday because that's what I used to do. But did you ask yourself sometimes when you go to church, am I living for you today, God?
Yeah.
Or I just go to church because it's a tradition.
Right.
Right? God doesn't want us to have the tomorrow mentality.
Right.
Because you got it today.
Right.
God doesn't want you to have the tomorrow mentality because you will forget what God has for you today.
Amen.
You know, giving up should not be an option as apostolic. Giving up should not be an option for us as a son of God, a child of God. You know, growing up in a broken family, it was really hard for me. You know, growing up by my mom, it was really hard for me. I was asking God, you know, Lord, why this is happening into my life? I grew up in a miserable life. You know, growing up into drugs, into alcohol, and everything that you can think that is worse in the sight of God. I did everything of that. All of them. And one day I was in my bed, and then I was like, you know what, God, you are not moving in my life. You are not real. You are not real. And then I was like, I was about to end out my life. And God spoke to me in that moment. He said, you know what? I am not finished with you yet.
Right.
Amen.
You know what, church? Most of the time the enemy is trying to influence our thinking.
Right.
You know, he's going to be like, you know, you cannot do it. Even though you did your effort for it, the enemy will try to influence you that you cannot do it. You are nothing. But God said, you can do all things.
Right.
Not because of your understanding, but he said, you can do all things because of me, through Christ.
Right.
So what we need to understand, church, that we cannot do anything, but because of the help of the Lord Jesus Christ, we are everything.
Amen.
We can do everything.
Yes.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Job chapter 1, verse 21 to 23, it says, then Job arose and rent his mantle and shaved his head and fell down upon the ground and worshiped.
Yes.
And he said, naked came out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. The Lord gave and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yes.
You know, I draw my thoughts, church, when he said, fell down upon the ground and worship. You know, church, when we go into trials and we cannot do anything, we should do what Job does in his life.
Yes.
That he didn't do anything. He didn't complain unto God, but he said, you know what? I'm going to go on my knees and worship, because
yes,
he knew that no matter what situation he is in, God is always in his life. It's the same with us today. We've been struggling with this COVID and this pandemic. This has been planned by the enemy.
Right.
You know, the enemy knew that something's going to happen in this world. That's why, what's happening right now in our life, he's trying to influence you. You know what? You cannot do it. You cannot do anything. You cannot do outreach anymore. You cannot do a Bible study anymore because of a lot of restriction. But I come to tell you today, in the work of God, in the presence of God, there is no restriction.
Amen.
You can worship God at home. You can worship, oh, come on, somebody. It is not all about you, but it's all about God.
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You know, when I was reading about his life, the life of Job, I was like, I remember when I was in my downside, and I was thinking, you know what, Lord, I am not going to give up because of you.
Amen.
You know, we don't have to give up because of this COVID. We don't have to give up in our situation. When you don't know what to do, Job said, fell down in the ground and worship. Fell down in the ground and worship, because that's what we need in this world right now. If we want, you know, if we want the word of God to be in all nation, to be preached in all nation, we need to rise up and be the church. This is the time for us apostolic to rise up and be the church. Hallelujah. This is not the time for us to sit down, you know, to feel like we're alone, that we cannot do anything. If you believe that the Lord Jesus Christ is always with you, there is no excuses. You can go somewhere. You can go to Tim Hortons and say, you know what, God is good every day. You know what? The reason why I am here today, because God is always with me. Amen. You know, because it's not all about me. It's not all about you, but it's all about God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. We are not going to understand our situation until we said that, you know what, God, it's all about you.
Amen.
The only way for us to understand our situation, if we give our lives to Jesus. If we give our life to Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 1, says, now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, ye hath God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden. You know, the enemy is trying to give you false doctrine all the time.
Right.
You know, that, you know, even though you're trying your best for the Lord Jesus Christ, you know, you're trying to be holy. You know, you're trying your best to wet the altar for God. The enemy is trying always to tell them, you know what? No, don't do it. Don't do it. How about you find a work? How about you go to your friends, hang out with them, instead of wetting the altar for God? You know, over 3,000 promises in the Bible, the enemy is always trying to influence you in your thinking that you cannot do anything. That's why you ended up giving up. That's why you ended up giving up. But I'm telling you, church, today, that there is a power of not giving up.
Amen.
There is a power of not giving up. You know, if you knew that you're still waking up every morning because God is not finished with you.
Amen.
Yet.
Amen.
You know, the reason why you are here right now, because God doesn't want you to give up.
Right.
The reason why you're here right now, because God doesn't want you to give up in your situation.
Amen.
You know, when I walk into the room, earlier, I prepared a message, but God spoke to me and he said, no, don't do your way, do my way.
Amen.
That's why I gave a note again to the back and said, you know, I'm sorry, it is not the verse that I need. Because God spoke to me and he said, you know what, this is what we need in this place right now.
Amen.
This is what we need right now. I don't know you all here. This is my first time being here. But I can feel it in my spirit that some of you has been struggling into something. That sometimes you're about to, you know what, Lord, just take me. Just take me. I don't want this anymore. I don't want in this world anymore. Just take me. But God said, you know, stay there. I am not finished with you. I'm not finished with you yet. Don't give up. You know, we will come into our life, church, that we'll be questioning for everything. But God had the answer for everything.
Amen.
You know, when I was growing up in that situation that, you know, I don't know what's happening. But when I committed suicide and God spoke to me and he said, I'm not finished with you yet. And then after that night, that was Friday. I'll never forget that day. That was Friday. And then Saturday, we have a basketball game. My teammate, he goes to church, and I was like, you know what? Can I go to church with you? Can I go to church with you? And he said, for sure. And then I have a long hair. I look like a drug addict, because I used to be. You know, I have a pack of cigarettes with me. And then when I go to church Sunday, my pastor spoke to me, and he said, you know what? Stay in this place. You know, I am thankful for all our leaders, for all our pastors, our elders.
Amen.
Because, you know, when we were in our situation that we don't know what to do, they're the one that's always there for us. They're the one that's always there for us. You may not understand. You may not knew that they're always praying for you. They're always there for you. But in the moment, God spoke to me and He said, "This is what I'm telling you, that I'm not finished with you yet." I received the baptism of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. Almost a year in the church, I started Bible study, but I'm still smoking. I couldn't help myself. But one day I prayed about it, I fasted about it, I said, I was like, you know what, God, if you're going to use me in the ministry, if you're really going to change me, I want you to take away. I want you to take away everything that is not pleasing in your sight. And I was praying about it, and then one day I tried smoking again, and then it threw up. And I was like, you know what, God, it's done. It's done. I don't want this anymore. It's done. Because church, God will not be able to do His part if we're not going to do our part.
Amen.
God will not going to be able to do His part if we're not going to do our part. You know, being in Bible college, there's a lot of revelation. There's a lot of preparation. Last semester, I believe that's a year of preparation for all of us as students. Not only for students, but for the world, that we need to be prepared. Because if we believe that Jesus is coming soon, we shouldn't be just sitting down. You know, because if you believe that the Lord Jesus is coming soon, you should be doing something for the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We should be doing something for the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. In Isaiah 41:10, it says, "Fear not. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God.
Yes.
I will strengthen thee. I will help thee. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness." Church, you don't have to be fearful. Jesus said, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God." The question is, why are we afraid of this COVID if you know that your God is with you? I am not saying that don't follow the restriction, but if you believe that the Lord Jesus Christ is always with you, you gotta follow God instead of the restriction. Because if the Lord Jesus Christ is gonna come right now, I don't know what to say. I don't know if I'm gonna go to heaven. I don't know about that. But you know, in my best, I'm trying to do everything that I could for the kingdom of God, because I knew that if without God in my life, I couldn't be in the jail. I couldn't be dead right now.
Right.
Amen. Hallelujah. That's why, church, I encourage each and every one of us today that this is the time for us to rise up and let the world know that there is the Lord Jesus Christ working in this place. There is Lord Jesus Christ working in this place. Hallelujah. You know, in Isaiah 40:31, it says, "But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength.
Yes.
They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and they not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint." Church, our restoration has arrived.
Hallelujah.
Nothing is impossible with God.
Amen.
He can heal anything. What you've been feeling this past few days, past few weeks, He can heal anything. He can restore everything that the enemy is trying to take away from you. That the need, you know, the enemy is trying to destroy in your life. God will restore everything. You know, that we need, and the enemy is trying to, you know, to destroy our walk, and said, "You know what? Don't do it anymore. Don't do it anymore because of COVID. You're gonna get that COVID. Don't do it anymore." But God said, "You know, don't listen to the lie of the enemy. Don't listen to the lie of the enemy. Hallelujah! Because the Lord will destroy. The Lord will destroy the work of the enemy in our life."
Yes.
Because He can restore this church.
Yes.
He can restore this church if you believe that. If you believe that God can restore this church,
amen.
Hallelujah, we shouldn't be just sitting down. We should be doing something for the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you believe that there's going to be a revival in this place, Hallelujah, hallelujah. There's going to be a revival in this place. If you believe that there's going to be a revival in this place, why don't we worship? Why don't we worship the name of the Lord? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Church, if you believe that there's going to be a revival in this place, we need to receive it. Now we need to receive that there's going to be a revival that's going to happen in this place, despite of a lot of restriction, despite of this COVID. God is still able. God is still able to do everything and anything in this place, because He's still God in the throne. He's still the God of Abraham. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's still the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sometimes, church, we think that our capacity is not available. Hallelujah. But God qualifies us. He will restore our capacity. Sometimes we think that we don't have ability, but God will restore our ability. He will restore. He will renew our ability to serve. Hallelujah, hallelujah, because you're going to be in a different dimension. God will going to lift you up in a different dimension. But let me tell you, church, not all the time is you're going to be on top. Not all the time you're going to be on top in a different dimension. Sometimes you're going to see yourself on the ground running and walking. But God said, you know what? I don't care if you're running or walking. All I want to do is for you to continue for the kingdom of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. No matter what season you are in right now, just go on. Continue to serve God. Hallelujah, be faithful. Amen, hallelujah, hallelujah. Because He will restore anything and everything that is the promise of God in our life. Hallelujah, in this world. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Praise God, praise God. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God is in this place. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Why don't we lift our voice, our hands? Hallelujah. Let's worship the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, God, for being here. Thank you, God, for being with us today. Hallelujah, Lord, hallelujah. Thank you, God, hallelujah, Jesus, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's not all about me, Lord. It's not all about my understanding, my talent, but it's all about you. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God, praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We've been dealing with everything because of COVID. We put everything in COVID. Our situation at work, our situation in our walk with God, most of the time right now we defend it on COVID. You know, we limit God in our life because of this COVID. But I've come to tell you, church, today, you could be limited. You know, you could be limited. This city could be limited. This restriction could be limited. But our God is unlimited. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 That's why. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. That's why, church, I encourage the young people, especially the young people in this church. You know, if you think that, you know, God cannot use you, if you think that God will not be able to use you, yes, we could be limited. We could be limited in our own strength, in our own knowledge. But our God is unlimited. Amen. Our God is unlimited. God said, you know what, Lord? If I'm going to be a willing vessel, God will be able to use me. Yes. If I'm going to be a willing vessel, you know, I'm gonna go on the ground, and I'm gonna be like, Lord, help me. Lord, give me a desire. Give me a desire for the lost. Give me a desire for the souls. Because you know what, God, I am limited. Yes, Lord, I am limited, Lord, I am limited. But you are unlimited. Yes, Lord, I cannot do this. I cannot do this. Yes, I cannot do this by myself. But God said, you can do anything. You can do everything. Hallelujah, because there's a power in Jesus. Hallelujah, there's a power of God in your life. Hallelujah, church, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. When I was here in the church, I knew that God is going to do something in me. That's why I started to build an altar in my room. There's a place in my room that I always go. And I said, you know what, Lord? I said, you know what, Lord? I don't want to be just in the music ministry. I don't just want to be playing guitar, playing bass. But I want to be more of you and less of me. I want to be more of you and less of me. I started praying about it and I was like, God, give me a desire for the lost. Because I believe that, you know what, Lord, if you could restore my life before, you know, if you could restore that Jobert from the drug addict, if you can restore him and everything that he does before, he can restore other people as well. Hallelujah, hallelujah. That's my church. That gives me the desire. That gives me the desire to my co-workers, to my basketball teammates. You know what? Lord, when I go to that place, I don't want them to see who am I, but I want them to see who is in me. Who is in me? That is the Lord Jesus Christ in my life. Because I knew if they're going to see who am I, they're going to say, you know what, Jomer, you are a drug addict. You are nothing. You know what, you want to pursue basketball in your life. That was your dream. But if they're going to see who is in me, that is the Lord Jesus Christ. You're like, oh, bro, what happened to you? What happened to you? You know, what did you do? Why did you change? Why did you change? Why did you change? And I'm, you know, it is because the Lord Jesus Christ. And then that's the time. That is the time. God is going to use us. Because we go underground. We go underground. And then you know what, God? Lord, use me. Use me, because God said, if you're going to be a willing vessel,
amen,
I'm going to be able to use you. I'm going to be able to use you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Church, hallelujah, hallelujah. There is a power of not giving up. There is a power of not giving up. Hallelujah. Before going here in Bible college, hallelujah, I told to myself, Lord, I want to have a degree first before going to Bible college. I want to pursue basketball. I want to pursue basketball. I want to pursue basketball. But God spoke to me and he said, you know what? I don't want you to go to that school. I don't want you to have that degree. I want you to go to this school, to this specific school. He showed me the Bible school, Northeast Christian College. And I was like, why, Lord, why? My friend has a degree. Why you don't want me to have a degree? And I realize time to time that we have a different callings,
yes,
in this world. Amen. We have a different callings in this world. I was dealing with God. I'm like, you know what, Lord? I don't want to pursue Bible college anymore. Because I see my friends back in high school. They're all successful now. They have their job. They're earning money. I was like, you know what, Lord? I'm going to pursue. I'm going to pursue what I want. But God said, you can do whatever you want right now. But I'm telling you, if it's my time, you cannot do anything about it. If it's going to be my time, you cannot do anything about it. That's why, church, sometimes in our situation, we've been in trials most of the time. Because we've been chosen to do our ways instead of God's ways. You know, we've been trying to always do what we want to do instead of what God wanted to do in our life. That's why most of the time we're going to be like in the ground. You're like, Lord, 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 Lord. But when God spoke to us, we don't listen. We always, you know, in our situation right now, we always pray, you know what, God, do this. And then the Lord Jesus Christ is going to spoke to you. And then, Lord, I don't want to do this. I don't want to do it. It's too hard for me. That's why most of the storm in our life, it is not all from God. It is because of our ways. It is because of our in our way, because we don't listen to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. In Mark 11, as I close, Mark 11, 24. Therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you shall have them. Hallelujah. The word receive in Greek is lambano. It means that you need to receive it now, so you will have it later. You got to receive it now, so you will have it later. Hallelujah. You know, if you believe that this church gonna be a revival church, you gotta receive it now.
Amen.
You gotta receive it now.
Amen.
You gotta receive it now, because God, we're gonna do it later.
Yes, amen.
You know, if you believe that our unsaved loved ones will be with us in the church, I gotta receive it now. We need to receive it now, because our Lord Jesus Christ, we're going to do it later. You know, I'm the first generation in my family to be in the church.
Praise God.
You know, I'm the first generation in my family, because I grew up in a Catholic church. You know, I grew up in a Catholic church helping the priest while I was growing up. And then after the service, I go to my friends drinking alcohol, doing drugs. But because there is God in my life now,
yes,
I need to receive that my family will be in the church as well.
Yeah.
I need to receive that my family, my unsaved loved ones, will be in the church.
Right.
Because I believe that God will gonna do it later.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Church, do you believe that your family will be in the church?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Do you believe that this church is gonna be a revival church?
Yeah.
Do you believe? Oh, hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Do you believe that there's going to be a great revival in this city?
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. If you believe that there's going to be a great revival in this city, we need to do something now.
Amen.
We need to do something now.
Amen.
You know, for me being in Bible college, don't get me wrong. My perspective being in Bible college, I'm not only in Bible college to study the Word of God, but I am in Bible college to do the work of God.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm not just going to be a reader of the Word, but I'm going to be a doer of the Word.
Amen.
Because I believe that we cannot be effective in this world if we're just going to be a reader of the Word.
Right.
We will be effective if we will be a doer of the Word. Hallelujah. That's why, church, if we want a revival in this place, if we want our family to be back in the church, if we want God to move in our life, we got to do something now.
Amen.
We got to do something now.
Thanks.
You know, end times is coming soon. A lot of prophecies been happening now. Yeah. You know, I don't want to get to the point that one day the Lord Jesus gonna come and he said, what have you done? I don't want to go to that place and he's going to say, why you didn't tell to your family about me? Why you didn't tell your co-worker about me? Why you didn't tell your friend about me? That's why, because of that situation in me, I put it in my mind and my heart that my past is erased. My past is erased. I will testify. I will testify. Because in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, he said, you shall receive power. And he said that, you know, you shall be witnesses. If we're going to do it in our generation right now, in reality, you're going to be witnesses in St. George.
Amen.
In New Brunswick.
Amen.
And into Canada.
Amen.
Right?
Right.
Because that's what the Lord said. You know, if you receive that power, you're going to be a witness.
Amen.
He didn't say if you're going to receive that power, you're just going to sit down and relax, have coffee.
Right.
But he said, if you receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, you're going to be a living testimony.
Amen.
You're going to be a living testimony.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Church, as we stand, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Pray, hallelujah, that we'll put it in our heart that I'm going to be a willing vessel. We will be a living testimony in this world. Hallelujah. Because God will be able to do his part if we're going to do our part. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. We worship you. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. God, help us. Hallelujah. Open our heart. Open our mind, Lord. Hallelujah. That it's not all about us. Hallelujah. But it's all about you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Hallelujah. I believe. Hallelujah. This is the time for us apostolic to rise up and be the church. This building is not the church. We are the church.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This church is a house of prayer, but we are the church. Hallelujah, hallelujah. If we're having trouble to our family, to our friends, to our co-workers, to be in the church, let's bring the church to them. That's, you know, back home in our church, that's what my pastor always tell me. You know what? If you couldn't invite them in the church, bring them to church. Hallelujah. You know, like I said before, being in the church for a year, God give me a desire for more souls. When I go to church, when I go to work, when I go to my friend, I don't see them as my co-workers. I don't see them as my friends, but I see them a future Bible study.
Yeah.
I see them a discipleship one day. Hallelujah. I am nothing in the church. I'm nothing in the church. I don't have any position. But God said, you know, if you're going to be a willing vessel, you know, if you're going to be a willing vessel, you don't need any position in the church for you to rise up and be the church. Hallelujah. All we need to do, church, is to have a servant heart. That, you know what, Lord, I don't care if they don't see what I am doing, but you see. You can see it. Hallelujah. That's why, church, pray. I pray and I encourage each and every one of us today that this is the time for us to rise up and be the church. This is the time for us, apostolic to be the church. This is the time for us, you know, to be a living testimony. This is the time for us to be a willing vessel. Don't worry about your past, because in 2 Corinthians 5:17, God said, you will be a new creature. All things have passed away. You don't have to worry about your past, because there's new every morning. There's new every morning. You know, if you did those crazy things in the past, let your past erase. Don't go back in your past anymore. You know, don't go back in your past anymore. Hallelujah. Because you are a new creator. God doesn't want you to dwell with your past, but God wants you to dwell with him right now. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. We worship you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, church. Hallelujah. Don't worry about your past. Hallelujah. Because if you're constantly dwelling on your past, you are feeding the devil. You know, if you're constantly dwelling with your past, you're just letting the enemy know that he won the battle. But God said, no matter, like what the song said earlier, no matter what the enemy meant for evil, God will turn it for you. Praise God. Let's worship the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's come unto God today. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for ministering to us this morning.
Yes.
Thank you, God, for opening our heart, our mind, that we will be a willing vessel. Praise God. I'm going to, hallelujah, Jesus, hallelujah. I'm going to go out in this building because I have the victory. I'm gonna be victorious. Hallelujah. I'm not going to give up in my situation because God is always with me. Hallelujah. Church, God doesn't want us to be a loser, but God wants us to be victorious. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We don't worry about negative thoughts in our life. Stop being worried because of this COVID. Hallelujah. It is not the will of God for you to be worried. Hallelujah, hallelujah. It is from the enemy. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We worship. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
How many of you believe that God is in control? He's King of Kings. He's Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Thank you, Brother Gilbert, for that powerful message. Let's sing a little bit. Come help me. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory.
I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord.
Oh, I'm gonna see a victory.
I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory.
Greatest men in the Old Testament, one of the greatest men in the Bible. His story was included in the Bible, but he didn't even have a Bible. He didn't have the revelation of God like you and I do. He didn't have the book of Job to turn to for comfort and direction. He was the book of Job. But he found out there's one thing, that God is faithful.
Yes.
And even though you don't always understand the path that your life is taking, God has a purpose in it. Do you believe God's got a purpose in your life right now? Do you believe that all things work together for good to those that love the Lord? Hallelujah. Do you believe there's power in prayer in any situation that's coming against you? It's not coming to stay, it's coming to pass.
Yes.
Do you believe that God is using those situations to perform His will, to further His kingdom in your life? I believe that with all my heart. Hallelujah, that's why we sing. I'm gonna see a victory.
I'm gonna see a victory.
God's using it all.
For the battle belongs to you.
And you know what? Your battles are God's battles.
I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle.
Verse 2.
Belongs
There's power in the mighty name of Jesus. God's using this situation for His glory.
For the battle belongs to You.
Oh, say it again.
I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to You, Lord.
I'm gonna see a victory.
I'm gonna see a victory.
Be it unto you. And we get what we believe for. We don't get what we need. You know that God doesn't meet needs. God meets faith. Amen? Jesus said, according to your faith. You say, oh, I'm struggling with my faith. No, no, no. You're struggling with your feelings. Your faith is still there. You just need to feed your faith. Amen? Praise the Lord. I like to remind myself of every time God has come through, and I could write a book that thick. Hallelujah. I could write a book that thick of how many times God has. And you know what? If I sat down to write a book for how many times God has failed me, I couldn't even fill a page. I couldn't even fill a line. I couldn't write one word. You know why? Because He's never failed me. He's never failed me. And He's never failed you, and He's not going to fail you. Hallelujah. Thank You, Lord. Somebody told a story. There was three men sitting on the wall. Faith, feelings, and facts. Feelings fell off the wall and pulled faith off after him. But facts reached down and pulled faith up, and faith pulled feelings back up. Amen? The fact remains, God is faithful. I said, God is faithful. You can depend on Him. Place your faith in that fact. Hallelujah. And your feelings will come trailing along. Hallelujah. Praise God. Somebody say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. God is faithful. So just want to remind you that you can drop off an offering at the back of the church. And don't forget to put something special aside to support our young Bible college student. How many of you appreciate these young men? Amen. They're great young men. And all our young people, we love them. I wish they could all go to Bible college at least a year, just to get grounded, but we're going to support them. And don't forget the family. And how many know that God's going to bless us financially? God has blessed us financially. Everything we've done has been paid for. Say praise the Lord. And now we're reaching out. We're reaching out to be a blessing, and God's going to bless us more and more and more. And God's going to bless us with souls, precious souls. Hallelujah. And I don't say, God, bring everybody into the church. I say, God, bring the hungry. And bring those that want to obey the Lord. Amen? Amen. We want a church that serves the Lord, loves God with all their heart. Amen. Not just the crowd. We want people that love God. Amen. Amen. So put God number one in your life. I guarantee you, you will be blessed and you will be a blessing. Thank you, Jesus, for being with us today. And go with us, we pray. And continue, bring us back this evening at 5:30 for prayer and a service at 6 o'clock. And then on next Wednesday night for our Bible study, God. You're doing great things and we give you glory. In Jesus' name, everybody said amen. And let's remember Sunday school next week. Spread the word. Praise the Lord. We're excited about that. God.